Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophonet and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. I had to cut the previous episode a bit shorter, just because I, was running out of time. So we talked to the Sun King, and now we can actually talk to Erend and Blameless Marad? Marad, yeah. So I'm just gonna talk to Erend first, to see if he can tell us anything more.
So, I thought Ursa was dead, and I thought Durval was dead. Dead doesn't seem to mean what it used to. Well, maybe I'm just an ass.
Oh, you're only whatever. Just a little bit of an ass.
All I know is that it's time to find my sister and get some payback. I hope Marad's guy grabs us a lead.
Yeah, I hope that too.
Did Ursa ever tell you anything about Durval?
We were both under his command for a while. Sort of. Helped him recruit an army to take out the mad Sun King. But then he got real creepy with Ursa. Needless to say, she wasn't interested, but he wouldn't let it go. Not to mention the fact that we realized he wanted to murder every Karja, not just the bad ones. Long story short, he's a grazer-licking dungbag.
Fair enough, so he was kind of Ursa's stalker at the end as well.
Avad seems committed to finding your sister.
Yeah, those two got along. And some people say they shacked up, but I don't buy it. Seems a little skinny for her. Okay, some bad images are forming in my head. Let's just focus on finding her and kicking Durval's ass.
So yeah, kind of Durval... both Durval and Avad seem to be into Ursa.
Don't stand me up in Pitchcliff, okay? Ursa needs us.
We might go there straight away, but first let's talk to Blameless Marad. Maybe he can tell us a bit more.
Aloy. How can I be of service?
I don't trust this
it's
guy.
It's obvious that you're an advisor to the Sun King, but what is it you do exactly?
Whatever is needed, of course.
Are you always so evasive?
It depends.
That was evasive again. So what are your thoughts on the King?
You were right about Avad. He seems genuine.
He is the Sun King. I serve him the best I can. What else would you have me say?
Huh. Did you serve the last one as best you could, too?
Well, I served him to his enemies. It was the best I could do for the Sundom.
So you were the advisor of the previous king as well.
Nothing I can be blamed for.
Yeah, Blameless Marad. So, yeah, he was the advisor of the previous king as well, but he kind of served them up. So he must have been a contact for Avad inside of his father's reign.
Sounds to me like you're a spy.
There are many helpful voices in the Sundom and beyond. I like to think of myself as a good listener.
So a spy? Blameless.
So why do they call you Blameless Marad?
Well, it depends on who you mean by they, and what they might wish to blame me for.
Talking to you is tiring.
Indeed.
So they say.
Because he doesn't give a straight answer. Ever.
What will I find at the border?
An outpost full of Oseram, most of whom want nothing to do with Durval. Still, he inspires great loyalty in those who fought with him against the last Sun King. He will not be caught alone. And don't forget, he is a master craftsman. Nothing delights him more than his dangerous toys.
Yeah, and his brutal machine gun. So, do you have any thoughts about Durval and Ursa?
What makes you so sure Durval did this to Ursa?
I don't care for sure or certain. I prefer likely or probably. How many Oseram are clever enough for this ruse? Capable of building the weapon you described? Who hate Ursa so? More than one? Not likely. Durval? Quite probably.
Likely and probably.
Even if people think he's dead.
That is surely another reason to be suspicious of certain words.
Indeed, so thank you, Marad.
I have to go.
Then you must.
We kind of got a bit of information there. There seems to be something over here in the back as well. I'm just gonna take a look around. The Sun Kings, a record made on sun-worn parchment. Oh, it's another big one. So that's all the kings that were king before Avad. And Avad is described as the liberator. And Jaran, his father, who was in his early years... who in his early years was a strong Sun King, defending the Sundom from the encroachment of other tribes, and the derangement of the machines, but who came greatly addled and ordered the spilling of much blood in the sun's name, threatening to bring a twilight time upon us. Okay, there we go. That is something we've read now. Is there anything else around here? Doesn't look like there is anything. There were some documents near the king himself. Just gonna quickly check those out. So there's something on the other side of his throne here. Founding of Meridian. The founding of Meridian. We are Karja, and us is the blood of those led by Aramand from persecution and pursuit so long ago. Out of the far savage east we came, guardians of a treasure greater than land or metal, the leaves of the Old One. Adaman found the leaves in a ruin picked out by a beam of sunlight, and he recognized at once their importance. Within was etched the first teachings of how to observe the sun, to recognize its guidance and to understand the place of men. From out of the leaves came the first glyphs, the first writing, so our knowledge could last longer than voices. But when our forefathers offered to share this gift, they were driven out by those they had once called tribesfolk. These ones feared to have the light of knowledge brought to bear on their ignorance, or were jealous of its power, and so began the long wandering of our people, trusting only that the sun would guide them and deliver them from the barbarian tribes. The path was hard and marked by the stones of families who fell along the wayside, even Adaman's own. The persecution was unceasing from those without purpose, only the desire to debase and destroy. But the fate of the Karja was rewarded with a distant vision, a tower like a solid ray of the sun holding on the horizon, flashing. Even as their enemies descended upon them, Aramand followed the flight of the Glinthawks, leading his people through looming canyons and teeming jungles. Again they saw the tower, so close now it seemed to reach to the very sun itself, and they saw that the Glinthawks perched upon it. Beheld in the light of the sun, the tower, the spire, cast its long shadow upon a mesa across the verdant valley. Adaman knew he had found a haven for the tribe, as this was a place shunned by those without his faith, who cowered from the magnificence of the spire or the shining feathers of the Glinthawks. He named this place Meridian from a passage in the leaves, and the tribe settled in the protection of the great mesa. They found the site was blessed in every respect, carving their cliff houses from the bounteous resources, and in time from the red rock of the mesa itself, crowning it with the first columns of the City of the Sun. Truly, the sun gave much to the descendants of our forefathers, granting Meridian great harvests and prosperity, and the bounds of the sundom for as far as the light touched. In time, seeing Meridian shielded us from the dark arrows and plots of our foes, all the foreigners brought trade and tribute. Holy Meridian, without spire and sun, there would be no Meridian, but now and forevermore it stands as monument to both. And the glory of Aramand and the founders is reflected anew in each Sun King of the Radiant Line and the noble houses of the Sun Court. Okay then, interesting. So they started the city just because of the spire. I can't really find it at the moment. Where's the spire? Why wouldn't the king be able to see? Oh, it's right over there, peeking out from behind the city. So that's the spire. Interesting. So let's head down and out the city, and we're gonna head towards Pitchcliff. So see you guys, well, closer to that destination in a second. So we're back to where we found the proof that Ursa was still alive. That was up there. But we're also very close to where we need to be to finish up the Robin the Rich quest. So the quest where we followed a thief that stole a certain sword, and then they sold it apparently to help out the poor. But that's something we still need to find out. But that's right over there, so I'm gonna head over there, and then after that we'll start working our way to making our way towards Pitchcliff. And this doesn't seem to work. Oh, damn it. On the rock, and then in the water again. Never you mind. Okay, let's cross the water. And then let's move over there. Oh yeah, another thing I wanted to talk about is I did a few more hunting ground trials while I was, in between recordings. And I actually leveled up a lot from that. For some reason, they give you a buttload of experience if you manage to complete a trial. I almost leveled up every time I completed a trial. So now I'm level 28 and I have a lot of skill points to spend. So let's check those out. The Strong Strike Plus would be cool. But we do want to be careful that we... Speeds up healing, doubles the capacity of the medicine pouch. Would be handy as well, but I think I'm going to go for Strong Strike. That's one. After that, maybe... faster reload? I don't think so. Maybe I should go for combat overrides. Or ammo crafter. We're starting to have more weapons, so maybe craft additional ammo from the same amount of resources. So that would be nice. There we go. And then we have one more left. Maybe I'm just going to speed up the healing from the medicine pouch and get that one skill point out of the way as well. There we go. There we go, indeed. So that means how many arrows can I now make this immediately? So 12. So that's good. So this is where indeed Asan was meant to check in, but he's not here. So let's check out the campfire right here. Might as well quick save immediately as well. So let's take a look around. There we go. Scraps of cloth. Here,
but no body.
Anything else we need to check out? Doesn't seem like there is anything else, so let's just check this out.
If someone dragged Nassan off, there should be tracks.
Okay, then, fair enough. I think I can almost see the tracks.
Let's see where they went.
Yeah, over here. I can actually follow them by sight as well, because you kind of can see them in the dirt here. I do need to look forward, because I don't want to be spooked by a giant machine all of a sudden, because we're pretty far into the desert. Are we going towards that Shadow Karja fort? Because there was talk of a fort. Might have been that one as well, but there are two here. Because over there is something else. Striders. I don't think I need to... No. No need to antagonize the Striders. They don't seem to be annoyed by me walking this close either, which is interesting.
Let's hope Nassan is inside.
Huh. So this is indeed the Shadow Karja outpost, but they won't be so interested in me getting in here, probably. Oh, yeah. Yep, they're definitely not interested in me. They definitely just want to murder me. So I am going to start taking out these guys. Now, this thing is, of course, interested as well. Just going to take out the Strider first, then, because he's going to annoy the fuck out of me otherwise. There we go. You know I'm out there. Well, do you know what happens if you get shot by a double precision arrow? Death. Death. Just simple death. So 7 arrows every time. So let's take out their outpost guys over there. This is just too funny. These guys don't even know where I am. We just keep murdering everybody in this camp, aren't we? Shadow Archer. Well, they're not doing their job really well. Just quickly gonna save over there. But as far as it stands right now, I don't really have a problem at the moment. Killed pretty much everybody I could kill from outside. I kept walking for some reason. There we go. More slag shine glass. Anything else? How do I enter this? Or do I just move in? That is...
They've got Nassan, all right. He needs help.
Let's try this again. I'll keep it simple since you're obviously feeble. What?
Oh, snap. That was a problem.
Can't take another!
Oh, hi. Oh, shit.
Stay close.
Oh, shit. There we go. There goes that guy, and I think that was it. Okay, then. What's this gun? A fire striker, so I think I saw this before. That was actually pretty easy. They just came running out of the door, and that was kind of a bottleneck for them, which made it easier for me. So that means that everybody's supposed to be dead. Thank you very much. And then let's free Nassan. Hello, sir.
Andy, you've sent me. Let's get you out of here.
I thought that old salt had abandoned me. Guess I owe him a slap on the back. Come on, this way.
Don't we need to talk first? Okay, then. Where the hell are we going? There's a perfectly normal front door if you want to. Everybody's dead anyway. Okay. Do you have a grappling hook of some sort? Because it seems like you only have rags. Okay, never mind. Apparently that's a normal skill in this world. There we go. Dropping down. Ow. And there we go. So, Karja, Shadow Karja Fort taken care of that. Medicinal Valley Herb. Thank you. Just gonna pick up a few while we're at it. And then let's talk to Nassan again.
Kandiv told me about the cause. Did you lose the shipment?
No. It's hidden nearby. There's a lot of hungry people in Sunfall that will be happy to see it.
Good. Now, listen. When you head back to Meridian, talk to a noble named Ravon. If you're honest with him, I think he'll help.
Beg a high blood for help? Ugh. But after everything you've done, I can't refuse. But for
yeah,
now,
dude.
I'm bound for Sunfall. Be safe.
Yep. Okay, you too. Are you just gonna sit down? Robin the Rich returned to Ravon. I'm not gonna do that just yet, because of course we're starting to get closer to Pitch Cliff. That was it. Pitch Cliff. So I'm gonna start heading further there, and I'll see you guys there in a second. And there we go. A long trek, a pretty long trek with a strider. And that pulled us to Pitch Cliff, sort of. Which means I can actually dismount. Yeah, there we go. I'm just going to quickly save at this campfire. And then we should be right next to where Erend is supposed to be. Hello, good sirs. I'm here to help. I come in peace. Yeah, these guys are wearing hammers, so I'm supposing these are the Osaram freebooters that are in the Red Guard.
This must be Pitchcliff. Murad's agent should be at the marketplace by now.
Okay, then. But we need to go to Pitchcliff, right? We don't need to get back to Meridian again. Holy shit, this is cool. Hello. Oh, yeah, so Pitchcliff was the border to the Osaram area. Let's quickly... Oh, hello. Oh, so the marketplace in Pitchcliff.
No,
that's where he's supposed to be. Never mind.
Plenty of time to invest.
Misunderstood that.
We'd better look for him.
Damn right.
Okay, meet Murad's operative. He's not here, but I'm just gonna check out with this merchant here. Okay, there we go. Just sold a few things. Check this supply crate. Now, we need to find the operative that Murad has sent out. There's just a supply crate. Highlight track.
Well, someone left here recently, and they were in a hurry.
So let's hurry after them then. Hello? Okay, down here in this little alley. And then it just stops. Oh, that's a problem. He's dead. Like completely,
that's
utterly dead.
Durval's thugs must have made him.
Maybe because he found something. Look at this. I think he drew a map with his own blood.
Right. Those kind of maps you know you better follow.
That might be Pitchcliff. He marked a spot to the north. Could be Durval's location.
And my men are waiting outside of town. I'll grab them and meet you there.
Okay then. Splitting up again. Examine the operative's body. Done. Now we just need to head to that camp. Yeah, okay. And then we might as well move forward with this. Oh, hello, Erend. Yeah, go. Just go. So I think... Can I actually just fire at this turkey? No, okay. So these are their turkeys. Osaram guys are ready to go. And now we just need to head towards the camp. It's not that far off, actually. And I'm thinking that's still my strider, right? Just take a few of these things. Thank you very much. And let's get back to on my strider. There we go. And take this bad boy into Durval's camp. He won't expect a strider running into his camp. Oh shit, what is that? A Ravager. It looks like... yeah. At least two Ravagers, and I think that's a Stormbird up there. Shit. Might have to run around this place for a second. Just gonna dismount, because this strider is... pulling too much attention to me. Durval's camp. I could try and take out the Ravagers. Might not be that hard, I presume. Since we kind of know how to take these guys out now. So I just go...
machines like you. I found the right cauldron.
There we go. Take out their guns. And then get over here. And then shoot him to Kingdom Come. Oh shit. Oh shit, where the hell is this guy keep coming from? And I'm dead. I'm gonna try this again. I know going for the cannon is a pretty good plan.
Surprise.
Think that did that. There we go, there goes the cannon, and now I need to set this guy on fire. Jesus Christ. So that's the Watcher down. Do I get his cannon somewhere? There it is. Come on, 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 come on. Whew! Where's the other? Where's the other one? Where's the other one? Ah, I'm out of bullets. Fuck it. Okay. Ravager, thank you. Where's the other one? There were two. Okay then, never mind. Think I did that pretty well, second go around. But I think there's another one around here somewhere. I killed that Watcher. I think the other ones are a bit further away. Probably, ooh, that is not... what the hell is that? I don't know where that second Ravager went. I know there were two. I'm just gonna craft a few fire arrows. Oh, and it's one of the heavy snap maws, so I need to be careful here. If I use shock wires, because these guys are pretty dumb. They always go for a straight line. So if I now aim at him.
Let's make this quick.
There we go. I need to take those off. And three arrows. And then if we swap the fire arrows, we can actually set that on fire. Now we need to move back. There we go. Nice big explosion. Yeah, okay, there we go. So that's the snap mall down. There's somebody else interested in me. I'm just gonna quickly check out this guy. He fell for my trap. And now I just wanna check this out because I need to focus here. Woo! He's gonna explode, he's gonna explode. Yeah, there he goes. Woo! Oh, there goes the other one. Yeah, I was on the blaze. On the blaze canister. He's gonna explode in a glorious explosion. Thank you for all your loot. They actually do have a lot of nice loot, these the snap moss. So with that done, just gonna heal quickly. Take the chill water and get on my way. Because yeah, as you can see, we're starting to get into rougher territory where the bigger machine starts following up a lot faster. I actually get a few blazes and chill waters here. And there's a campfire, which is really, really good. Because that means I can save before we head any further, which apparently pretty high up. Which also means I'm going to take a little break. So when we get back, we're going to assault Durval's camp, if it is even there. So before that, I'd like to thank you all for watching with the glorious Stormbird over there in the background. And if you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. That thing is creeping me out. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.